struggle with it, but the first thing I think you have to do is choose. It's like making a garment. I found this outline. I thought it was very, very fascinating. First thing you want to do is choose the fabric that you're going to work with. The weight, the color. And I usually find that I work with patterns when I sit down. That's the first thing I do is I'll... Are you a pianist, I presume? 2 cents each.
So fair.
But hey, I'm not worried. Why don't you just take that in case somebody else comes in? So I'll catch you up. We were talking about when you're starting an arrangement. And it's true of anything. Be it your voice or piano. You want to choose. You need to know what you're doing. Why am I arranging this? What is this pronounce? A vocal setting for church. For an auditorium or something. Or piano arrangement for a prelude or whatever. So you've got to make that decision and you can have it. We're talking about. Which is like. What's the feel of the piece going to be? Shells, look at arrangements, listen to classics. I mentioned this yesterday. Mozart loved to play billiards and would, break the balls and listen to the cracking sound of the balls and listen to the rhythm that was there. And he'd go, and that would mean, this is their work on that. And then but I'm sure that it wasn't just that. You know, he was a brilliant, brilliant musician. And brilliant musicians find inspiration everywhere. Listening to the sounds of nature. If you listen to the wind blowing, you can hear a rhythm or hear a feeling. If you listen to water gurgling, you can hear a rhythm or a waterfall or birds singing. How many composers have got inspiration from birds? All of those things, if you open up your eyes, there's stuff everywhere that can lead you to some musical idea, if you're willing to look. What we'd like to do, do you have pencils? Too far. Who knows what he goes to? Up for it. A7. The dominant 7. So far. Now, in your mind, step here.
Very good.
Oh no, I can see exactly what you're doing.
Thank you.
just have the bottom half of the garment. We want to add something up here. So think of, I'm going to challenge you to do this, think of something the right hand could do that's different than what the left hand is doing. Could be a chord, a half note melody, an interval. No. I'm just thinking about getting us moving. So the left hand, we've established a left hand pattern, I assume we have, of some kind, on those first four measures. And then give the right hand something simple to do. Sit here and make several arrangements for you. You're going to direct me, but you also have to find your form. You have to plan how you're going to do the arrangement. And a simple A, B, A, C, A always works well if you're arranging a hymn. Verse, intro, with some pattern. Chose two chords on beats 3 and 4.
Thank you. sure you weren't thinking about this because you're thinking about all the musical things. But at the top, we have that simplicity of Hear Our Prayer, and then underneath is all the turmoil of why we need to be asking God to hear our prayers.
Exactly. There's, I think we subconsciously do things like that as musicians. I don't know if you were thinking about the turmoil of life and the need to express it, but you're right. It comes out. We analyze a lot of music back in college, which was a long time ago for me, but it was always fascinating to hear if you had a room full of people listening to a simple piece of music, analyzing what was going on and what the emotion was under it. You're going to get a lot of different answers. People feel a lot of different things. And that's one of the beauties of music. Is it speaks to everybody in a different way. I love that. Questions so far? Okay, is this the idea of doing this makes a lot of us really uncomfortable. I can see it when you don't have share. Is it? You gotta let your ideas out, though. I'm not gonna force you to do anything, but I'm gonna encourage you. You came to this class thinking this might be kind of interesting to figure out how to arrange for piano, not thinking you were going to be forced to do it today.
Well, it's different when you're not at the piano, because I can sit with just a basic melody and expand all over it, but like when I'm just this, it's much harder.
Okay. Could I talk you into showing me? It would be so good for the class. Come on, just show me what you might do.
How I'm going to teach that to you.
No, that's okay. That's okay because working from your head on paper is really hard. I know.
Thank you.
really solid beginning to a beautiful piano, and don't give away all your goodies right away. So, say, all right, good. No. We're gonna make this. This is gonna be Tchaikovsky tonight. Now, repeat your pattern. Do it again.
Thank you.
he did a couple of interesting things. I'm not sure you were hearing it as a reflection of any other piece of music, were you? Okay. I heard the Bach bell canon just a little bit. And that's a wonderful arranging tool. And finding any little pattern that people are familiar with or just something you stumble on. I know you didn't, that was not intentional, that's just what I heard. Because whenever I hear that chord progression, I hear Bach bell. Probably because in the publishing industry, we get an arrangement every day based on Bach bell canon. But play this right hand melody. Very pretty.
Thank you.
did on the cuff was pretty remarkable, as was with you. You have an awful lot of ideas in there, and that's a good thing. But as you're arranging, as you're working, try to find them and focus them a little bit. Look at what you're doing and pick out one thing and really make that the important thing that continues throughout life. Thank you.